Greetings to everyone. My name is Navin Yadav and I am faculty of physics at Rao Public School. Now in today's video we will be learning about the force experienced by a charged conductor in a magnet. So let us learn that. That is force. So let us, we are at a conductor which is placed somewhere in the magnet. Okay, the length of this conductor is L. This is the length of this conductor, and this conductor is having a cross section area of A. Let's suppose n number of electrons are present per unit of volume into this conductor. Okay. Now, total number of electrons in this entire conductor will be, if you multiply the number of electrons per unit of volume with the volume, then we can calculate the total number of electrons in the conductor. Okay. So, the force is force on one charge multiplied with n number of charges, then the value of force, as we know, the force is qvb sin theta. This is the force that we derived formula. Now multiply this with number of electrons, that is nal, and this is qvb sin theta. Now, we studied this thing in the chapter electricity, that A, N, E and this V. Okay, this is what? This is a current which is flowing into this conductor. So, as we studied in the chapter electricity, what we can say? Current is N, A, Q, B. Here this B is drift velocity. So we can write down the force experienced by this charge current carrying conductor is I, L, B and this sin theta. We got this transform, so by substituting current as N, A, Q, B. All these things, that is this N, A, this is Q and this B. Or we can substitute these terms as current, and this V is drift velocity with which electrons are moving into the charge conductor. Okay, so the force experienced by current carrying conductor in a magnetic field is BIL sin theta. Now there are some cases we can draw out of this, that if theta is 0, in that condition what force that charge conductor will experience? That if sin theta is 0 and sin theta is, we are putting the value of theta, then sin theta becomes 0. That means there is no force experienced by the charge conductor in the magnetic field. Current carrying conductor in the magnetic field, that is, it is minimum. If the angle between the magnetic field and the current carrying conductor is theta is 0. Okay, now second case, that is theta is negative. Now what will happen? Again use the value of F, that is B I L sin theta. Substituting theta as 90 degree, then what will happen? This term will become 1. So the force experienced by this current carrying conductor is BIL, that is the maximum force. It means if the current carrying conductor is perpendicular to magnetic field, then it will experience maximum force. Okay, so now we are having only one conductor. If we are having two conductors, then what will happen? So let us understand that force on two parallel, so we can make it two parallel current carrying conductors. We are having two parallel current carrying conductors. The name is A, B. In the conductor AB current, let's say I1 is flowing. And in the conductor CD, let's say current I2 is flowing. Okay? And the current both I1 and I2 are both flowing in the same direction. Now we know the formula for magnetic field generated by a current carrying conductor. I did the derivation. Magnetic field produced by a current carrying conductor at a distance r, that means these two conductors are separated by distance r. So magnetic field will be mu naught I divided by 2 pi r. I is the current which is flowing. So magnetic field developed by the first conductor is mu naught I1 divided by 2 pi r. Okay. And the magnetic field developed by the second conductor, we can write the expression as mu naught I2 divided by 2 pi r. This is the magnetic field developed by the second conductor. Now come to the previous derivation. How much force a current carrying conductor will experience if it is placed in a magnetic field? Now these two conductors are present here, in which current is flowing. Okay, so what will happen, that current, this conductor AB will experience a force because of the magnetic field developed by the charged conductor CD. And this CD will experience the force because of the magnetic field developed by the conductor AB. Okay, so the force experienced by the conductor 1 is because of the magnetic field developed by the conductor 2. Current is flowing into the same conductor and the length of the conductor. Okay, and the force which is experienced by the second conductor is magnetic field produced by the first one, current into the same conductor 2 and the length of the conductor. Okay, so we can use these terminologies and we can calculate the force. The force experienced by one just substitute the value of B to magnetic field produced by second. That is mu naught I2 I1 divided by 2 pi r and the L. Now force by second, it is F2 is equal to mu naught I1 I2 L divided by 2 pi r. By observing both the expression of the force, we can conclude that the force is equal in magnitude. All the terms which are using in, we are using in the expression are same, are equal. Okay, that means F1 and F2 both are equal in magnitude, but they are opposite in direction. How we can calculate the direction? We can calculate the direction of this force by the help of Fleming's left hand rule. We know that if we stretch our thumb, forefinger and middle finger in such a way that all three are perpendicular to each other, okay, then we can calculate, estimate the direction of the force in which it is acting. Okay, so if a current is flowing in the same direction in both the conductors, then they will attract each other. That means parallel forces, parallel currents, they will attract each other. And if the direction of current is reversed in one of the conductors, then they will repel each other. We can conclude that anti-parallel current will repel each other and parallel current will attract each other. So it is F1 equals to F2 but is negative sign. Okay. So I hope this concept is very much clear to you. Thank you very much.